200 or something truck rides rough. You ain't seen rough till you move one of these things. So Derek's on the 726 over there cutting with it. Our 830 is down. Had some kind of back a couple of months ago. Let me get Scott first here. Yeah, let me get Scott first, and then I'll probably get you there, friend. So back here. During the summer, we had some kind of manifold on the, it's not a like an engine manifold, it's hydraulic manifold. On the 830, it cracked and busted or something, and we lost an entire week in the woods waiting on a part to get here. We couldn't run without it. And we had to have, it was a job where we had to have the track cutter. Well, that same part, a couple of months later now, has done the same thing, and not sure what's going on. They installed it, the dealer installed it, and all that good stuff, so we're waiting on the part to come in now. It's supposed to be here today at lunch. It's almost lunch, and so we brought the 726 up here to run it, you know, to get us by. It went down on Friday about the middle of the morning, and then so today is Monday. Just moved loader sets. So that's what I was doing, was tracking a new set. Okay, Scott. Tracking a new set. I'm gonna finish this load as quick as I can. Get it done. Atmosphere that we're in right now, getting parts is not the easiest thing to do. You know, I'm tipping right now, see, I just sit back down.
Yeah, got it.
All right, I'll get you next, friend.
Okay.
what I got the most of compared to what I've got loaded on the truck. Take off slide, I don't think. Saw. No. Probably not gonna have enough steel to finish his load. He got a load of pine pulp wood.
$7.26 over there. And there's the 8:30. I don't know if a mechanic's coming tomorrow to fix it up or not. I'm not sure. We'll see. I never heard him say if the part came in today or not either. Maybe it did.